Newton third law of motion. What did the second law says? It says force is directly proportional to acceleration and mass. Okay. So the external force on the body causes certain acceleration. From where does this external force act? What is the origin of this external force? What is the agency which is providing this external force? When we talk about Newtonian mechanics, the external force is arising due to some other system or body. If you consider two bodies, say A and B, then B gives rise to external force on A. Now the question arises, does A in turn give rise to an external force on B? That is, if this is A, this is B. If A is giving some force or thrust to B, what is B giving to A? If you press a coiled spring, the spring is compressed by the force of your hand. The compressed spring in turn exerts some force on your hand and you can feel it easily. But what when they are not in contact? Bodies are not in contact. For example, Earth, it pulls anything downward due to gravity. Now, what is stone doing with Earth? Means if this is Earth, there is a stone or any other body. Now, Earth has a tendency to bring the item back, body back, because there is a gravity. Center of the Earth has some gravitational pull. Now, when it falls or when it is falling, does this stone also provide or gives some or resultant force on this Earth? The answer is yes. And what is that force? We can't feel it. The mass of this body is very less. This stone is negligible as compared to the mass of Earth. So we don't feel it. According to Newtonian mechanics, force never occurs singly in nature. These are two bodies. So the force is the mutual interaction between these two bodies. In other words, we can say that force always occur in pairs. And the mutual forces between two bodies, they are always equal and opposite. And this idea is expressed by Newton in the form of third law of motion. That says to every action, there will be always an equal and opposite reaction. So this is quite crisp. You know, this line is very crisp, very beautiful also. And in common language, we can say like this. But because of this simple line, there may be some misconceptions. We need to, you know, point out certain important facts about the third law. What is action? What is reaction, especially? So the term action and reaction in the third law means nothing else but the force. Action reaction means force. We can use different concept, but that will be confusing. So we'll stick to the force. A better way to state the third law will be force always occur in pairs. So force on body A by body B is equal and opposite to the force on body B by body A. The action and reaction pair in third law, they may give some wrong impression that action comes before reaction. Action is the cause. Action is the cause and reaction would be the effect. So there is no cause-effect relationship implied by the third law. And the force by A on B or A by B and the force on B by A, they would act at the same instant. In the same reasoning, any one of them can be called action and reaction. So action and the reaction forces, that is FAB, force on A by B, and they act on different bodies, not on the same body. So these are two pairs, A and B, So this is A by B, force on A by B, and this is force on B by A. So if we are considering the motion of any object, say A or B, only one of these two forces may be relevant. It would be an error to add up these two forces, and we can not claim that the addition of these two is zero. But when you are talking about a system as a whole, means this is for this scenario, it is not acceptable. But when we are considering a system that is two bodies as a whole, that is FAB and FBA are the internal force which are acting on a system A plus B, both the bodies are involved, means you consider them as a system. Now they add up to give a null force, and internal forces in a body of a system of particle, they will cancel away in pairs. And this will be very important. We will see in next discussion also, and solving the questions also. Let us take an example. Two identical billiard balls strike a rigid wall with the same speed, but different angles. One like this, and one with certain angle. What is the direction of the force on the wall due to each ball? What will be the force? And the ratio of the magnitude of impulses imparted to the balls by the wall. So what will be the force imparted or applied in result to the ball striking it? And we'll use, see, the very intuitive answer will be, you know, might be the force on the wall will be normal to the wall like this. And in this case, it is inclined at say 30 degree. This is 30 degree. But this intuition may be wrong. The forces on the wall is normal to the wall in both the cases. So they will be normal, means perpendicular. This perpendicular, this perpendicular. So they will be, in both the cases, they will be normal to the wall. So how we are going to find out the force on the wall? There is a trick. We'll consider the force or the impulse on the ball due to the wall using the second law. And then we'll use the third law. Means, let us say that u is the speed of each ball before and after collision, because the speed is not changing. And m is the mass of the ball. Say m is the mass of each ball. Now, we will consider axis as given in this figure, and also consider the change in momentum of each ball. In this case, first, if this is u, this is m, initial momentum is m into u, then this strikes the wall and comes back, returns back. So the velocity, first of all, it was in this direction, then it will be in opposite direction. So the px in this case will be this direction, py is 0 because this is normal to the wall. So mu and then return minus mu. So this is px initial, px final, and the py in both the case will be 0 because this is normal, perpendicular to, if you can find it, you know, the cos theta, u cos theta, u sin theta, you will find out that ultimately the y component is going to be 0 because of the cos component or the theta component. Now, impulse is what? It is the change in the momentum vector. So, mu, this is the resultant, m minus mu, minus of mu, that is minus of mu, minus mu, and that will give you minus 2 mu, and if you add these two, that will be 0. So, y component will be 0, and in this case, the impulse and force are in the same direction. The force on the ball due to the wall is normal to the wall because it is not going anywhere. And this will be along this negative x direction. As you see here, the sign is also showing that. And if you use the Newton third law of motion, the force on the wall due to the ball is normal to the wall. That is in the positive x direction, right? The magnitude of force, we cannot ascertain since the small time is taken for the collision, and which is not specified in the problem. So we'll leave it at that. Now let us come to the second part. It is striking and coming back like this. This is the direction and this is the direction. So what will be the px initial? That will be mu cos theta c. If I make this as cos theta and this as sin theta, this is theta. The direction is like this. So what will be the px? Always, if you have any direction like this, x component is this and y component is this. In this case, we have x component and this is what the y component. So x component will be mu cos theta and y component will be minus mu sin theta, right? In this case, px finite is going like this. So what will be the x component, which will be again, because in this case, if this you take cos theta in this direction as plus, in this case you have to take it as negative, right? Because in this case the cos is like this, in this case the cos is like this, so it will be minus mu cos theta, but the y component remains the same for both of these. Okay, so it will be minus mu sin theta and this will be minus mu sin theta. Now this px, the x component is changing sign after collision. See, mu sin theta and this is minus mu sin theta, while this is not changing. Now what will be the x component of impulse? Mu cos theta minus of mu cos theta, that is minus 2 mu cos theta. And when you add these two, means minus mu sin theta, not add, we have to subtract. Minus mu sin theta minus of minus mu sin theta, that will be plus mu sin theta. These two cancels out and y component will be 0. So the direction of impulse in this case is, as we saw, it will be the normal to the wall along the negative x direction. And using the Newton third law, we'll find out the force due to the ball, which is normal to the wall along positive x direction, and the ratio of magnitudes will be previously what it came. It was this value. Then we got this value. Divide 2 mu by, rather minus sign will be cancelled, so 2 mu by 2 mu cos 30 degree, which will be 2 by root 3, which comes to 1.2.